This video is sponsored by Single Point Solution. Single Point is pioneer in production and distribution of electric vehicles like electric bikes, electric scooters and three-wheelers. Single Point also provide consulting services to small F players.
Hello friends, I'm Kanchan from Aculmec Technologies and welcome to Top Brass. Today we have a very, very interesting discussion about a person who is in news for some time, and he's Arnab Goswami. Arnab Goswami is SME's and is born in SME's family of Colonel Manoranjan Goswami and Suprabha Goswami. So to discuss about his personality, his kind of journalism, I have Sitesh Srivastava, who has a deep interest in corporate training. He's been working in different continents and is closely associated with radio broadcasting. So Sitesh, welcome to the show. How are you today?
Thank you, Kanchan. It's a great day on this side for my side, and I'm sure it is a good day for you as well. I am really, really well and very, very charged up, just like Arnab. How are you?
I am fine. At my side also, things are good. Weather is well. Unlike there's no pouring of rains now. So things are perfectly right. And as you know, we are discussing about Arnab, who is trending. He was number one journalist at the moment in Indian subcontinent, I can say. He's also a recipient of Ramnath Goenka Award for Excellence in Journalism. And as you know that he started his career in 1995 with Telegraph and NDTV. And later on, he also joined from 2006 to 2016 in Times Now. And currently, he is heading Republic Media Network, which is trending and also having highest TRP. So what do you think about the TRP and other aspect of this news giving away?
Well, Kanchan, first of all, I do not believe in any histrionics. I come from the great legacy of the Doordarshan news reporters, All India Radio news reporters, Shammi Narang of those days, if you remember, and Salma Sultan and others of Komal G.B. Singh, Geetanjali Iyer, and you name it, you have it, including Pranoy Roy, who is now the chairman of NDTV. And so I believe that ratings don't last. Good journalists do. And the other thing is that journalists should be watchdogs and they should not be lapdogs. So in today's life, it is more about the room is filled up with so many journalists, so many media people. And one of the sure shot way of to be heard is to be loud. And therefore, I believe that Arnab is doing a great job. He's really loud. He is overboard. Decibel levels are too high. Really tests a television's decibel limits. And therefore, he's doing a great job. Content-wise, I will have my reservations. The content, the presentation. Yes, histrionics, 10 out of 10. Content, I will have to keep it for some more deep thinking. So yes, that kind of journalism is flourishing, has been flourishing. I mean, today it is Arnab. Some years back, we had someone, you know, few other journalists like this. But as I said, in a crowded room, the loudness is a great skill. And therefore, Arnab is doing a great job. Republic TV has been compared to, I mean, a lot of some criticism is also there, which is there, I mean, part of parcel of the game. There is criticism about it. And at the same time, he, as you said, he has got Ramnath Goenka Award, but that was in 2008. And he has been, some news broadcasting agency, he has been president as well. But to say that he is not articulate, which I would think, because I always come from a belief that the argument has to be better rather than the voice, rather than the decibel. Whichever debate it is, whether it's a debate on a television or it's a debate in a parliament, what do you say?
I believe some part of your argument at this point of time, but I feel one aspect which is very crucial and very solid when we talk about Arnab is that rise of nationalism, which is, I think, is a requirement of this hour, because we somehow started saying that India is not bad, it is a bad country, and there's no facilities. And we have somehow, the young generation especially, left the feeling of proudness about their country, their culture, their tradition, and the various things which India offers. So I think in one way, Arnab has ignited this issue and this very crucial aspect to feel proud and rise of nationalism. I agree that he is loud among all journalists. But then I also feel that the choice of topics, especially the controversial topics like Thurur deformation case, or we have remarks on Keralite or Palghar mob lynching. These are few crucial issues which he has discussed. And one more point is that he's the one person who is responsible for starting debate on news channel. So that is also goes, I think, a plus point when it comes to journalism, especially in India. What are your views on this?
No. I agree. I completely agree your point about the rise of nationalism. But I would say, Kanchan, that nationalism doesn't come with one label. Nationalism is not about one label, one political party, one ideology, the most popular ideology, or and it is also something, it cannot be claimed that one is a better patriot than the other, because there is no scale for it. There cannot be a scale for it. Ultimately, everyone functions under the constitution and the words written in the constitution. So to say that nationalism's rise, yes, it is being seen, it is being observed. But to say that that is the only brand of nationalism, it is incorrect. And therefore, I always recommend to my family, to my friends, to my colleagues, sometimes please go and watch Doordarshan news as well. You will be happy. You will feel peace. You will feel at par with what is happening in the country, and you will not see anything that is only sensationalizing 24 hours by the time. And I am so proud of Doordarshan that even in today's hullabaloo of all these, you know, branded journalism, Doordarshan still remains, Doordarshan News, English or Hindi or whichever, they still remain the best news channel. And at least the moment you watch all the other news channels and you come back to Doordarshan, you will feel at peace. You will go and have a cup of coffee and you will think, oh, the world revolves anyway. It doesn't stop. And that is my whole point is all about.
So I think that you are more on the presentation type of issues rather than news or how it is.
I want content.
Okay.
I want content. And I want balanced content on so many things happening in the world. If you see one movie star's death has taken 100 days of television content 24/7 for one channel. You go to Doordarshan and you get the balanced news, what is happening across the world. You take up any international channel. There are sensitive news, there are progressive news, there are food news, there are leisure news, there are sports news, there are life. There is life beyond sensationalization, and I'm completely against. And you know, that is the reason the same thing happens to the Fox channel in America. Fox News channel is just based on this sensationalization. And so whichever party one supports, it is about the belief of the journalists. Can you imagine of the journalists of Doordarshan days shouting on top, you know, hurling comments, insulting comments, throwing words, and the words which are, you know, even probably a person like Mr. I can really think of a person like Mr. APJ Kalam would have been offended being on Republic Bharat. So I think that it is important to have a great content. It is important to raise the pitch as well. We need to raise the pitch. We have seen everyone does it. It is not just Arna. I only buy that content which gives me a balanced presentation, balanced content, you know, a balanced news, and at the same time, they can at the after watching for 2 hours or 3 hours in the morning, I should feel that I got a whole dossier of what is happening around me and not just one topic.
I agree with your point, but there's one issue which I differ is that you mentioned about this film star who is kind of a suspicion. In suspicion that he is being murdered, but there are people who are saying that he committed suicide. Now, no other channel, what I have gone through various channels, has taken up this particular story the way Arna has taken up. Earlier it was suicide, later on it came out to be a murder, a cold-blooded murder. So now when you see people only listen to you when you really speak loudly, and it should reach in your ear. It should make massive sound near your eardrums. So, I think I give full marks to Arnab to really taking up and coming out and giving a justice to a person who was claimed by many, not one or two, but most of the people that he has committed suicide. But it came out that he has been murdered, that too in a very bad way. So I give full support to Arnab in terms of his journalistic research, his people who are working in his team and doing a great work. And apart of presentation, I agree. I fully agree. The presentation may be very loud when it comes to Arna Goswami and the public channel. But as far as content, I feel any topic which he takes up or any of his team member takes up, they have some content in that and they have the capability and there are possibility which can really give dent in the journalistic outcome and then in the news itself. So that is one thing which I appreciate about Republic and especially Arnab, because as you mentioned, though Republic TV has been compared with North Korean media and of course Fox News in America TV channel, but apart of this, I just gone through all the criticism. I really feel that Arnab and his channel has that capability to reach to young mind and to really be listened by people carefully what he is saying. Unlike Doordarshan, though I appreciate, I worked for Doordarshan for many years, I understand that. And I have a soft corner for Doordarshan also. But though they are journalists, so they take a view which is like Om Shanti view, this 10% of this news, there's 10% of different segment news, maybe another 30% of news, and then sport news. So they are following a parameter or a sequence which I think need to change a little bit. What do you say?
Well, I can only pray that I can see Arnab Goswami in the league of Karan Thapar one day. I can pray that I can see Arnab Goswami in the league of Rajat Sharma, what he is today, what he has made of himself.
I think Arnab has left all these journalists behind. He is way ahead. I think because the kind of people appreciation he is getting, no other journalist has yet, except Pranav Roy, when he initially started NDTV. I can agree on this point. But of course, there are Rajat Sharma, who has a separate segment and separate fan following. But when it comes to comparison of Arnab Goswami with Rajat Sharma or any other journalist at this point, I think nobody matches him.
Yeah, I think that, you know, it's again, we live in a democracy, and like we choose our heroes and heroines, and we have to be choosing our journalists also. So probably Arnab has brought the stardom that was much needed in this space. So he has become like a angry young man of the news channel. And I wish he becomes Amitabh Bachchan of Indian journalism. If he really wishes to become an angry young man, he should choose to become the angry young man of the journalists of India. And I wish that he does what he does best. And I just wish that he raises his content quality rather than the decibel quality, just banking on that. Because decibel quality, in Indian democracy, we know that decibel quality rules for a good amount of time, but it does not sustain for a long time. And that's what is the difference between when we say Rajat Sharma or Karan Thapar or Pranay Roy, or MJ Akbar and all Sudhir Chaudhary's and Shekhar Gupta's of this world. So yes, we needed a star. We have a star. Arnab Goswami is a star of Indian journalism. I hope he carries on with this and he reaches greater heights. And he becomes dependable, more and more dependable.
Yes, I also think that he has started a different trend, especially in journalism, where journalists are not scared of putting their point of view. And I also noticed in his program that if you are a good debater, or if you have a point to really counter his point or anybody pro-government point, has been taken, appreciated, has taken well with the panelist. Have you noticed this kind of approach or attitude during his shows?
I have observed, Kanchan, that he doesn't take any comment negative. And that is the same thing as you have been saying. That's what you said. And I'm saying he's not taken even a pinch of salt from the other part of the argument. So that's why the being the loudness means my way or highway, which works well because people are paid to come on his channel. People come on his channel. People also go to other channels also. There are spokespersons. So interestingly, I heard that for the political parties, they have chosen a spokesperson to go to all other channels, and only very special spokesperson to go on our Bharat channel or Republic TV channel, because it is not easy to handle the heat and the salvo that he throws. So he is a great debater. There is no doubt about it. I think that his unique selling point is his voice, his loudness, his decibel levels, and combined with his actions going ahead, you know, launching FIRs and the kind of team he has developed. You know, his team will become as our IPL team of Indian journalism. In that T20 session, they will run behind, they will do everything to get a scoop, a worth of news from each and every matter that they are looking into, they are choosing and going behind. And but he is definitely riding a very, very thin rope in terms of choosing between the setup. And he must note, if he has to go very, very long way beyond the decades, where governments change, political masters also change, industrialists change, people change. If he has to go long way, he has to be a really, really a long-term player rather than a few years short-term player.
Yes, actually, his parental grandfather was a lawyer, and his maternal grandfather was elected legislator from Communist Party and served as an opposition. So no wonder I can understand from where this discussion and debating skills come from. But at the same time, I feel that Arnav has a lot of challenges to face currently, especially if we see today's scenario. And I also feel that being journalist is one of the fourth pillar of democracy. It has to be powerful and has to show people what is right and what is wrong. And I think more than 50% of work which Arnav is doing, I think it's clearing mind of people and showing across what's happening, especially when we see mob lynching, Palghar mob lynching. And I feel that he has long way to go and long way to really think about sustainability of this kind of journalism in India. What are your ideas?
Right. If he has to sustain, he has to be a long-term player. And that long-term player has to withstand many governments. In a 40-50 year career, many, many governments, many ideologies, regimes change,
right.
Electorate changes, content also changes, tones change, but the core, the ethics remain. I believe what he is being seen today, his core and ethics remain the same. He has no doubt inspired a lot of new journalists, young journalists. I'm sure wherever he goes to address these graduates, he gets a standing ovation. And his courage is commendable. But at the same time, the sustainability factor is also needs to be seen so that he can become MS Dhoni of Indian journalism or Amitabh Bachchan of Indian journalism, if he is being portrayed as such.
Yes, so all the best to Arnav, and let him keep giving good news and establish a good journalism in Indian subcontinent. So we'll be discussing more about different issues in our next episode. Till then, bye-bye. It was so wonderful to talk to you, Sitesh.
Thank you. The nation definitely wants to know this, Kanchan.
All the best. Thanks. Bye.